Why? Everybody ready? To Michigan Taskmaster. I am your Taskmaster, and with me are five people who performed a series of ridiculous tasks for the simple reason of doing it better than their opponents. I am the judge of these tasks, and my judgment is final. I'll be awarding between 1 and 5 points to each person for each task, and whoever has the most points at the end will become Michigan Taskmaster Champion and will win my golden head. Ooh. You know, when I'm walking down the street and I get recognized from Taskmaster, which is frequently, I always get asked, Aaron, why such stupid tasks, pointless activities? And I always chuckle and I give a single word response, Cthulhu. Because if I get enough people performing the right tasks at the right time, the great old ones will rise from their eternal slumber. And when Cthulhu's back running things, what's going to have two thumbs and is going to be responsible for bringing it all back and reaping the rewards? This guy. And maybe a couple of rewards for... So let's meet these contestants. Amanda Wilsing. Derek Kuhl. Gina Anzek. Pez Williams.
Pez Rules.
And Ryan Fust. Carrie, tell me that we're going to start this off in a completely new and unique way.
No, not at all.
Prize task, huh?
Our first task is the prize task, where the contestants bring in objects in a certain category, and whoever becomes the Taskmaster Champion will get to take these wonderful objects home.
Great.
Today's category is the most baffling thing.
All right, Amanda, what is your most baffling thing?
So, to me, the most baffling thing is not like... an actual thing per se, but it is, but it isn't.
I'm already baffled.
You should be, because it is actually something that all of us here have, every single Taskmaster contestant has in common, and that is the brain. The brain is maybe the most baffling thing to me. We all share one, but we all do things...
We're like a hive mind. We're the Borg. We share one brain. Yes.
The brain. And honestly, the most baffling brain is my own, as I'm pretty sure you all will see eventually through these tasks. So initially, my prize was going to be a day out with me just to get to know me and my baffling, weird little brain. But I felt massively guilty after performing my tasks. So I came up, as well as with the coupon for a free day out with me.
She's finally getting to it.
The representation of my brain. It is condensed soup, y'all. And
it appears to be like one of those shower things that you wash yourself with.
A loofah?
So, kind of, yeah, there's like glitter.
So let me confirm, this is the prize task. Is the day with you in addition to this prize?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. All right.
And the cool thing about this, as well as like all the little things that kind of represent me, like this is a dahlia flower that's in there. It looks the most like a brain, so I thought that's pretty cool. I also love serial killers, so of course. But there's like glitter, there's some chameleon mica powder that's
in there.
One
of these things is not like the others.
I'm just saying, this is a representation of the most baffling thing in its most condensed form. Plus it glows in the dark.
All right, Derek, what is your most baffling thing?
Well, I was thinking about who struggles with baffling things the most, and obviously detectives. So I went to some of the big names of detective work. Nancy Drew, The Hardy Boys.
Those are the biggies.
Jessica Fletcher, Murder, yeah. She Wrote.
Yes.
Hercule Poirot. Ooh. And Scooby-Doo.
Yeah.
And I found
those are
five.
The big hitters.
I found five of their most baffling cases. And I've taken those cases. And I've taken the pages. And I've mixed it all up into one most baffling mystery.
when Poirot wants to know about who's haunting the amusement park, that will be pretty baffling.
The most baffling mystery.
All right, that's pretty baffling. I got to give you that. So, Gina, what is your baffling thing?
My most baffling thing are AirPods. Because, okay.
They've been out for a while.
Every day I go to school, AirPods everywhere. Almost every single person in my school owns a pair of AirPods. It's just baffling because there's so many.
All right, thank you very much, Gina. Pez, what is your most baffling thing?
Let's see here.
If you're having a little boy,
this is just a snack for later. So just ignore this. Yes, these are
already baffled.
Utter baffle cookies.
Oh, I see. Thought they were unrelated. I was like, he actually brought cookies?
I did bring cookies. Actually, you don't need these gloves.
Are you baffled by your own prize?
Do you know what's in that bag?
No, I thought other people would be opening it. I present to you my ponytail.
Oh, what? Wow.
I figured this was a gift that would most baffle everyone else in the room.
It's so, a little baffling.
It is. So, yes, you get to own a piece of me, and I am a fairly baffling person, and I see some amazed faces.
How old is this ponytail?
Because I don't remember
you ever having one. Because it adds to the je ne sais quoi.
How long ago did you have a ponytail?
Yes, so I believe Taskmaster's known me for many a year.
So I'm guessing one more year back.
He's thinking way back.
And I can't help but notice it's not quite the same color as your hair.
This was cut in 2011. And I am a little bit of a hoarder, so I have kept my ponytail since then.
Where did you leave it? Like, in storage?
Just around.
It's right next to my commemorative plates.
It moves about on its own. It's kind of like a roommate.
It just shuffles along.
After midnight.
It's shockingly dust-free.
Yeah.
I do have a lot of allergies, so I it's keep things
curly.
Like this because
do you
of
dust
that.
It?
Yeah, I was worried about where it came from. Thank you, Pez. Before this gets any further out of
hand. I do have latex gloves for whoever wins.
Okay, thank you very much. Ryan, finally, please put us out of our misery. What is your...
Oh, I'm not going to do you any favors.
Oh, come on.
So, as you're going to find out later on, one of my hobbies is music. I am a musician. And so I decided to take this task literally, and the thing that baffles me the most is, of course, sound baffling panels.
Oh, it's literally baffling. Well, Carrie, this is very difficult, I think.
Is it?
Yeah. I mean, a lot of it was pretty baffling. I think for one point, I mean, that's literally baffling, if not actually baffling me, but I think for one point I'm gonna go with Amanda and her brain, because that was all over and I wasn't 100% following why it was baffling.
It's still a point.
I'm gonna give 2 points to Gina and her AirPods, because I think if that many people have them, they're not that baffled by them. Oh god, I can't give more. How am I gonna give more points to Pez's fake hair?
It's not fake.
If you swear to me it's not fake.
I have pictures of me cutting it, if that helps.
All right, I'll take your word for it. Don't show me pictures. I'll give you three. I'm giving you 3 points for your...
Oh, come on. You're killing me.
And 4 for the baffling, because even though it is technically baffling and fits it, it's not especially baffling. And I will give 5 points to Derek. Carrie, that was a fine appetizer, but I crave the raw red meat of an actual task.
Well, our first task has our contestants at a loss for words.
Write down 5 unusual words.
Read the task out loud, Pez.
Yes, because write down 5 unusual words that you have actually used in writing or conversation prior to today.
Good reading.
Exciting.
Well, hold on to that excitement, because it'll be important for later on.
Tantalizing yet unfulfilling. Do we have a task where anything actually happens?
We do. We had one that put the contestants out of sorts.
This is harder than they make it look. Sort the M&Ms. Your time starts when Carrie says begin.
No M&Ms may remain in the original bowl. When you are done. No M&Ms may remain in the original bowl when you are done.
You may not eat the M&Ms.
When you are finished, say done. Fastest wins.
Seems straightforward, Carrie. I do want to apologize on this one because Amanda's audio was not fully present. So when we see hers, it won't be quite as good.
Well, here we have Amanda, Gina, Derek, and Ryan.
I guess just straightforward.
I have to put them in rainbow order.
Suspicion, not all of these are M&Ms.
I feel like this is too simple, like I'm missing something. I don't know.
I just know there's going to be clips of someone who would figure something out much quicker.
I don't know what to say. I just, it's annoying. Ah! They keep rolling away.
Curious how Ryan did with this task, because he's colorblind.
This is awesome because I am partially colorblind.
Yeah.
Now, if someone were to just start stuffing M&Ms in their pockets, do you think the Taskmaster would look favorably upon that?
They might. I feel like I'm missing something. It seems straightforward.
You never know. Okay. Okay.
I don't know. Okay. What are you? Are you an M&M? Can't eat them. Okay, that's an M&M. Yeah, okay. Right? Yeah, I'm okay. I'm fine. I'm doing fine.
Nope.
Now I'm starting to think that I'm actually just good at this. Even though it feels like I've been doing this forever. Kind of feels like I was born to do this. And if there's a job in this, I am, I guess, looking.
There's got to be somebody somewhere who does this exact job for a living. Wants to just go home, unwind. They're going to watch this. They're not going to relax.
Why are they so rolly? Why'd you guys have to pick the peanut M&Ms? Because they're more rolly, misshapen, they hate me.
I'm going to guess I'm at the 10-minute mark right about now.
No.
I got it? No?
Okay. Now, I feel like I should also sort them by how many are in each one. And I'm not going to count them because I forgot to, but done.
Done.
Excellent. Thank you.
Okay. Done.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Done.
All right, Ryan, partially colorblind.
Yep.
That would explain the tracksuit.
Yep, my black leather jacket.
Gina, I appreciate so much your heavy size because I know for me, if somebody told me your car was just crushed by a meteor and these test results aren't looking too good, I go, oh, geez, what's the next step do we have to do to fix this? But if I'm in the middle of doing something, I drop something on the floor, I become so enraged, so irrationally angry. So every time you would sigh, I'm like, yeah, I know exactly what you're feeling. Derek, have you found a job sorting M&Ms in a factory?
No, I'm going to stick with teaching for now, I think. unfortunately. All right. There's not a whole lot of openings in the M&M sorting field.
You do have a knack for it.
Thank you.
He did look pretty happy. Amanda, were you eventually satisfied that they were all real M&Ms?
I'm still not satisfied that they were all real M&Ms.
I'm still waiting for the penny to drop.
There's right? Something
yeah, there's something.
Yeah, was there some like workaround?
Carrie, they all felt like they were missing something.
What did you do?
This either went really well or really poorly. I'm just not quite sure yet.
Did the test say that they had to sort by color?
It did not.
Excuse me. I think we have one more to go.
Let's see what.
Sort the M&Ms. Your time starts when Carrie says begin. No M&Ms may remain in the original bowl when you are done. You may not eat the M&Ms. When you are finished, say done. Fastest wins. There must be a faster way to do this. Glad you picked peanut M&Ms. Does make this a little simpler. I'm going to put as many of the colors in one bowl as possible, and then put all the colors for those colors underneath that one bowl. Red, brown, blue, green. Orange and yellow.
No.
Wait. Done.
All right. Pez, you had the idea of combining the colors in one bowl. That was perfectly legal. Really, as long as you had a sort method that did separate them somehow, it would have been, and you stuck to it, it would have been legal. You could have said, these are the M&Ms I scooped in my first scoop, and here are all the rest. As long as they were sorted by some logical manner, then that would have worked. So, Carrie, did that hack that he figured out save him any time?
No.
No.
He was about
to say, you still had to sort them anyway.
Yeah, he was about the same time as everyone else. But there is another clip I need to show you.
Oh, no. Well, there you go for your, well, I won't put it in there, but.
So, not only did Pez's hack not save time, but he left one on the floor.
And after that?
Yeah, he had dropped a few on the floor and he retrieved most of them, but he had left one behind.
Oh.
He didn't fully sort his M&Ms. And, he got 0 points.
Disqualified.
But there is another clip I need to show.
Oh, no.
Another one?
When you are finished, say done. I mean, I'm almost done. I'm done trying to think of what the clever solution is going to be here.
Oh, my boy!
Ryan? Yes? You said done.
I say a lot of things.
So here's the thing. Carrie, I really struggled with this one because he said done, but they weren't all sorted yet. But it also says when you are done, say done, and he wasn't done. So he did say done when he was done, if you can follow this whole thing. So I am going to allow it. But you came very close. I want you to watch yourself in the future. Not Pez. Pez didn't finish. Hey, so what was everyone's times, Carrie?
I'm glad you asked. Gina took the longest with 10:20. Ryan took 9:20. And there were only 6 seconds difference between Derek and Amanda. Derek took 8:50 and Amanda took 8:44. So 5 points for Amanda, 4 for Derek, 3 for Ryan, and 2 for Gina.
So people who did it the most boring way got the most points, Carrie.
Yes.
We are off to a rip-roaring start.
Well, remember how the contestants had to submit 5 unusual words they've used in a conversation?
It's been haunting my every waking moment.
Well, here's why they had to do it.
Choose 1 egg of each color. Okay. Okay.
Why am I overthinking the eggs?
Are these the same color?
You didn't think I would choose that one, did you?
And here's where it comes to bite me in the ass.
Inside
Each egg is a word that one of your opponents has chosen. Write and perform a love song for the Taskmaster that includes all of the words from your eggs. You have 20 minutes. Your time starts now. Shoot, dang. This is going to be fun. Alrighty.
Write and perform a love song.
All right, so I got hippopotamonstrosopquipedaliophobia, fear of long words. All right, so someone's already a liar.
discordant.
Pipsqueak. A person considered to be insignificant.
Oh, gobbledygook. I love that word.
Oh, no. Oh, my God.
Why? So the first word that I'm looking at here is pneumono-ultra-microscopicillus-sovlecanocaniosis. Rolls right off the tongue. Who wrote that one?
Prestidigitation, that's magic tricks. Awesome. Okay, okay.
Metamorphos or metamorphose? Metamorphosy?
Hachi machi? Exclamation of surprise.
Onomatopoeia?
Egregore, a non-physical entity that originates from the collective thoughts of a group of people. Okay, I can work with that one.
Toke. A small cap having a narrow brim.
Well, now I feel a little bad for the words I chose. I mean, I guess discordant metamorphosis are kind of unusual. I mean, that's the idea. They're unusual. Okay. Dudity. Male nudity.
Portcullis. A strong, heavy grate.
Here's a word I've never heard of. Forcola. A Venetian rowlock. All right, can I get the definition of a rowlock?
Deciduous, a tree that sheds its leaves annually.
Upstink, to make something smell worse. Okay.
Quintessential.
Ectoplasm, a supernatural viscous substance.
Ooh, gruntled. If I didn't choose that word, I'm thinking whoever did is super awesome. I love gruntled.
And last but certainly not least, we have discombobulate. Disconcert.
Yeah, I'm not much of a rhymer. I'm not much of a poetry writer. So writing love songs is not quite in my wheelhouse. I feel sorry for whoever got my words. So I'm gonna punch whoever wrote this directly in the thigh. I
feel like any love song has to have "oh baby" in it.
Physical tasks? Sure. Got me running around filling up all of these boxes? Sure. Got me trying to get the ball far? Sure. Put the bean in the thing? Sure. Write a thing using these words? No.
I just keep thinking about the words I chose. And I feel really bad for whoever got them. I'm sorry.
How am I supposed to write a song with ectoplasm in it?
Word onomatopoeia. What's your favorite word that sounds like it is? Carrie? Meow? Because you're a cat person?
Sure.
All right. But then what rhymes with meow?
I went to college for music theory, you know. Dropped out after a semester, but I still went.
Okay. Ah! I'm loving it.
Man, this is just not good. Just on the premise of this shouldn't be music.
Gina.
Sorry.
Feel
Feeling bad about those words, are you? Well, you've got Amanda wanting to punch you in the thigh, so if you need to be walked out to your car, let us know.
I'll be in the bushes. Just
I didn't know what it was for. It's not my fault.
I wanted to be very clear that one of our contestants is underage, and the task was worded specifically to say write it for the Taskmaster, not necessarily to the Taskmaster, because I don't need the press looking into my house parties. So, whose song are we going to look at first?
We're going to listen to Pez first.
Oh, excellent. Pez.
Oh, baby, onomatopoeia, I want to be with ya. You make all the cats meow. All I want to know is how I got so lucky to know is how I got to be this gruntled. I want this to last until old. Your beauty is like a forcala. It opened my eyes like my sinuses to a ricola. This song is like a bunch of gobbledygook, but your love I fell for like a hook. A baby on a monopia, I wanna be a with ya. Yeah.
A little bit.
So, Pez,
yeah?
You mentioned that every love song should have "oh baby" in it. But most of them don't mention the person's blocked sinuses.
Well, you know, we all love in our own ways.
Boy, yeah.
Love is messy.
And that's where I'll end that. I do want to share a text that Pez sent me after he was done, and I asked how he did. He said, and I quote, "I think my song was a strong entry." And I want to know how you feel about that after watching it back.
I feel my song is a strong entry.
All right. Who is next?
Next is Gina.
Oh.
You are my pipsqueak, my only pipsqueak. You hachi-machi, my portcullis. My ectoplasm was stole by aliens. Please don't take my ectoplasm away again.
How's that?
Yeah.
So, Gina, I have a couple questions. So, just about the plot of the song. So, apparently, maybe you're a paranormal investigator, and you,
yes,
for some reason, have ectoplasm sitting around, perhaps in a,
yes,
jar. Okay. And then, in a fun twist, aliens stole it from you.
Yes.
And yet, you're pleading with the person you're singing to not to take the ectoplasm away. Are you then in love with one of the aliens? I was a little lost on the through line there.
Is that story true?
Yes.
Wow. I mean, that kind of makes me like the song more if it's a true story. All right, next song, please, Carrie.
All right, here's Amanda.
Taskmaster, you stole my heart with your bow tie and fancy took. When you accepted my submission, my heart was absolutely shook. There was no chance for me, you know, emotional prestidigitation. Doing any task for you fills me with anticipation. There's nothing you could do that would cause any upstink, because the task you set for me always makes me think. And with this last refrain, with little else left to say, please, oh, please give me 5 points. Hippopotamostrosoequipedopolophobia.
I like your song. It's good.
Well done.
Carrie, do I wear a bow tie?
You could.
I could, but I don't.
So,
do you have anything to add about your song?
Oh boy, I took the lyrics back home with me as like a fun little memory. I don't remember any of that, honestly.
I'm trying to forget it right now. Carrie, what's the next song?
It's Derek.
Wow.
Taskmaster, sweet Taskmaster, You are so triumphant, Taskmaster, sweetest Taskmaster. Though my song is discordant, how to describe your features and all of their grandiose beauty? People's minds were blown when they saw you in your duty to put my feelings into a song. Though they're quite monumental, to metamorphose my love for you, and your appearance is quintessential. Taskmaster, sweet Taskmaster, never one point in my heart, not two, not three, not four, always 5 points, 5 points in my heart, 5 points in my heart, 5 points in my heart.
Derek, do you have anything to add about your song?
I think it speaks for itself. My truest feelings.
Oh, wow.
Especially the 5 points.
All right, we must have one more left.
Yes, we have Ryan.
Between us, I shed my leaves and you will live like a deciduous Aaron. I'm off beat, I'm sorry about that. Let me go without drums. Oh, Aaron, finally for you, I'm gonna spell the name of a lung disease that you get by inhaling San Diego.
Carrie, I gotta put some points on this. So I think
I mean, you put my song up, I'm hinged. I'm saying it's a solid third place.
I think if you put your song next to others, or indeed any noise or random traffic, or, then it's still probably 1 point. So you're gonna get a 1 point for that. I think I'm gonna give 2 points to Gina. And Gina, the only knock against yours was just that the words weren't in any context. They were in there, but they kind of weren't. Than to say
but
what they meant.
It was a story.
There was a story. And I didn't join the alien abduction twist at the end. But I think Amanda's was 3 points. I think, you know, you didn't have the music going on in the background, but the lyrics were very good.
I didn't want to make it worse. Let's see.
Was bold. Like, so I was then, impressed with the acapella.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
So then the big question is between Ryan's and Derek's, because here's the thing. I think Derek had better lyrics, but he also had easier words to work with, and the performance was a little better on Ryan's, and he had harder words. So I'm going to give Ryan 5 points, and I'm going to give Derek 4.
Entirely, yeah. Thank you.
So, Carrie, all the singing is nice and all. Do we have a task that's got some hair on its chest?
Yes. This task is not what you expect. Tie these ropes together in a way that will take Carrie the longest to untie. You have 15 minutes. Your time starts now. Where's the second rope? This rope. Okay.
Smart.
Just tie a ton of really tight, teeny tiny knots. I should have tied them together, like made a rope out of knots and then tied that rope into knots.
She tied quite an intricate knot. Is that a 5-pointer?
Well, tied to the end of the red rope was another task. Thank you. Present the entire red rope to Carrie. The rope must be untied, complete, and uncut. Fastest time wins. Your time starts now. Make me untie the stuff I just tied. And I tied it so well that I can't untie it. Done. Fully untied. Mm-hmm. All right, thank you.
Gina, how did it feel when you read that you had to untie the knot that you had to actually tie in the first place?
Great.
It did. She gave us another sigh. By the way, your mom was on last time we did Taskmaster, and she gave the exact same look during a couple of the things that we did. So I can see the family resemblance. Carrie, how long did it take her to untie that knot?
4 minutes and 44 seconds.
Okay, so who do we have next?
Amanda, Derek, and Ryan.
Tie these ropes together in a way that will take Carrie the longest to untie. You have 15 minutes. Your time starts now. Okay, so great already.
You have 15 minutes, your time starts now. Okay. Oh, hello. Is this a thing I should open as well?
Tie these ropes together in a way that will take Carrie the longest to untie. You have 15 minutes, your time starts now. Okay. And I assume these two? All right. And you know what helps is I did take a semester of music theory. All right. Present the entire red rope to Carrie. The rope must be untied, complete, and uncut. Fastest time wins. Your time starts now. I feel like I cheated this somehow. Red rope. You're welcome.
Present the entire red rope to Carrie. The rope must be untied, complete, and uncut. Fastest time wins. Your time starts now. Okay. Here you go, Carrie. It is untied, complete, and it is completely uncut. Is it though? Wait. Oh, wait. I'm gonna say it's completely untied. You know what? Yeah, I'm done. I'm gonna call it.
Present the entire red rope to carry. The rope must be untied, complete, and uncut. Fastest time wins. Your time starts now. Yep. Okay. No bonus task on blue. Blue is pointless. I don't need blue. I found you this nice red rope. It is untied, uncut, and un-something. Complete! It is complete.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah, Ryan, it's a little like cheating, isn't it?
It felt like it.
Yeah, I'm glad that semester of music theory is coming in handy for you. Oh. Did you cheat at that too?
I won't tell.
Carrie, what were their times?
Ryan took 2 minutes 22 seconds, Derek took 1 minute 46 seconds, and Amanda took 20 seconds.
Hmm. Carrie, did anyone actually do the task?
Well, let's see Pez.
Oh, no.
And remember that Derek did say that the blue rope was irrelevant.
Tie these ropes together in a way that Carrie will take the longest to untie. You have 15 minutes. Your time starts now. Is it tied to something? Well, I'm going to ask, is it tied to something? Or can I just pull it? Oh. I'm assuming it is okay to open this. It would seem to be logical. I wonder if I should pull in the blue one first.
Oh no!
I'm gonna pull the blue one in. Hey, Carrie. Would you come down here and sit on this bench for me? Hey, Carrie, do you have a safe word? Tie these two ropes together in a way that Carrie will take the longest untie. What have you done to this horrible blue rope? But there's a knot! That's not acceptable. Can't just leave things knotted. Look at this. Ooh. Look at this. It's getting better. This is not entirely necessary, but... Excuse me. Oh, you're part of the knot. You comfortable? Mm-hmm. Good. You want to hold this?
Your smile is like...
Now, why do I feel it's going to say untie, Carrie? I got 2 minutes. I use them.
No!
You comfortable?
Okay.
All right, good. Oh, hey, I found the end. Present the entire red rope to Carrie. The rope must be untied, complete, and uncut. Fastest time wins. How do I get you out of this one? Oh!
Thank you, Pez.
Done.
You had a real thing going with that blue rope. I mean, get a room.
I just wanted it to be straight and untied.
Yeah, but Pez, Carrie, he's baffled me. Carrie, what was his time?
He spent 9 minutes with the irrelevant blue rope before he even started tying me up. And then he went back to the blue rope. But the untied knot took 10 minutes and 43 seconds. So that's 1 point for Pez, 2 for Gina, 3 for Derek, 4 for Ryan, and 5 points to Amanda.
All right. Yay. Carrie, I tire of knots and ropes. What do we have next?
Well, here's a hot new task that just dropped.
Oh, what a tear. That one was good. Carrie will release the ball in 20 minutes.
Make the ball end up furthest from Carrie.
You may not touch or move either the ball or Carrie. After the ball drops, you may not affect its movement. Your time starts now.
Make the ball move the furthest from Carrie. Can't move Carrie. Can't move the ball. I mean, there's a big old hill.
Is there like a shed of tools?
Yeah, there is indeed a shed of tools. So I'm assuming that they're going to be making some kind of ramp of some kind.
They did. Let's see. Derek, Pez, and Ryan.
Okay.
That sure seems like that'll go straight down. I wish I could get the ball to go downhill. I am not a physicist.
Any opposition to me blowing it away?
In my head, this is going to be the greatest version of Mousetrap the world has ever seen.
I was giving the ladies my good side.
Okay, this is the thing. I like this. That's pointless.
I'm imagining almost like a Rube Goldberg kind of. It's got to go down a ramp, hit a certain thing, bounce off of something else.
I keep thinking I'm having great ideas, and then I look at it, and my confidence wanes.
Don't film me not knowing how to use a ladder. Come on. Right here.
What am I doing?
I'm just trying to figure out speed versus angle, you know?
Caitlin Clark, let's go. Give it time.
Oh, well, that went better than expected.
I'd say that I'm disappointed, but I kind of expected that.
Because it was well spotted that you did need the ball to go downhill. Good for you on that one. Derek, did that end up looking like the world's greatest game of Mousetrap to you?
I wasn't ever good at Mousetrap.
Explain some things. Ryan, why did you not completely open the ladder and then use it as a big long ramp?
Did you see how much I was struggling?
Yeah, you got a point there. Carrie, how far did they go?
Well, Derek went 84 inches, Ryan's went 104 inches, and Pez's went 163 inches.
Pez rules.
Pez, you're in the lead!
Yay!
For now.
Carrie, who's next?
Let's see Gina.
I'm scared. Carrie will release the ball in 20 minutes. Make the ball end up the furthest from Carrie. You may not touch or move either the ball or Carrie. After the ball drops, you may not affect its movement. Your time starts now. 20 minutes. Do I make like a ramp? I'm going to try to get it to roll down the hill, so the hill does most of the work for me. Come on. Oh.
Go!
Go, go, go!
Oh. It was so close.
I tried to blow on it.
I want to address the Three Stooges here. Did you guys see what she did?
Oh,
she built a thing. She ripped a box apart with her bare hands. She ran tests and then made improvements. Pez, you put a board on a gas can and called it a day. She is like DeWalt. You guys are Boeing. You should be ashamed of yourselves and feel bad about your attempts.
Always.
Wait, so how far did mine go?
Before we hear the distance, I think we've got one more person to see.
Yes, Amanda.
Yeah.
But you're gonna be starting from there then.
Yep.
So my thought is I'm gonna try to make a ramp. But yeah, baby! Real good audio of me just panting and hopping, breaking all these boxes. Gonna get all the YouTube subscribers.
Thank you. Ooh, oh my! Oh.
Hoping it's gonna be it. Otherwise, I'm gonna look like a fool. You know what? It's gonna work. I have faith in my little chewy slide. Yeah. Oh no!
Amanda, did it not occur to you that the tape might impede the progress of the ball?
So there definitely was a point where Carrie was over by my little slide and everything. And I looked up at the ball and I'm like on the ground. I had like the tape and I'm looking, I'm like, that should fit underneath there. But then nice. I was setting it up again after it, you know, fell apart, and I was like, that's not gonna make it, but maybe it'll bounce, like it'll hit the tape
go
and
low.
Go over, yeah. And then kind of gets momentum, but
didn't happen though, did it?
It's tape, it's stuck.
You know, there's a certain magic to simple.
Okay, well, depends. Where she's concerned, not where she's concerned. Carrie, what were the eventual distances?
So Amanda's ball traveled 43 inches.
Whoa, wow.
Which is shorter than me, by the way.
Yeah. Well, and that is the most brutal takedown you've ever given on Taskmaster.
That is a rare thing to find.
But Gina's went 272.
Carrie, I'm exhausted. What are the scores so far?
So we have Pez at 9 points.
Pez rules.
Gina at 13 points. Amanda, 15 points. Derek, 18 points. And Ryan, 19 points.
All right. Carrie, there's so many more to go. What do we got next?
This next task is sure to turn you on. Here are Ryan and Derek.
Nothing turns me on like Ryan and Derek.
Never a good sign when you have extension cords just running into an adjacent room with a button that just says on and off. All right. Figure out what the switch turns on. You may not move or disassemble the switch, the wires, or move any furniture. Fastest wins. Your time starts now. Okay. Let's see where they go. Okay.
Fastest wins, your time starts now. Okay, so right now I hit off. Okay. May not move or disassemble the switch, the wires, or move any furniture. Okay. Cables, 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 cables. Cables, 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 cables. Cables, cables, cables. Ooh. Cables. Oh, can't move them. Okay, well, there's things on the desk that are on. Lava lamp's on. Computer is on. Lamp is on. I hit off to start. There's this CD player, the cool CD player, alarm clock maybe. That is off. The lights are on. The fan is on. Okay. Okay. So off, on. Okay.
It's that. It's that thing. I'm done.
Well done.
Found it.
Thank you.
That's clever. That's clever. I like that.
Carrie, how long did they take?
Ryan took 2:22 to determine that the switch turned on the task in progress sign, but Derek only took 1:46.
All right. Who do we see next?
Let's see Amanda and Pez.
Oh, what the switch turns on. You may not move or disassemble the switch, the wires, or move any furniture. Fastest wins. Your time starts now. All right.
Fastest wins, your time starts now. Okay, figure out what the switch turns on. Not move or disassemble the switch. Okay. Wires, remove any of the furniture. Okay. Oh! It's the same. there we are. It's that.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Task in progress.
Oh, those guys seemed a little bit faster. What were their times?
Pez took 1 minute, 12 seconds, but Amanda took 20 seconds.
Wow, nice. Did you think you did really well? And you were like, I crushed this. Because I left that one feeling so good.
I didn't feel that way about anything.
I was like, I'm so clever. I got the best peripheral vision. I saw that. No one else did. I was so proud of myself.
I work with wires and electronics for a living. So I was like, I've got this in the bag. I'm going to do okay.
Oh, we got one more person, Carrie.
How long do you think Gina took?
Figure out what the switch turns on. You may not remove or disassemble the switch, the wires, or move any furniture. Fastest wins. Your time starts now. The sign.
Excellent. Thank you.
That was quick.
That was easy, wasn't it?
It felt too easy.
Listen, let me tell you what's wrong with young people today. You don't appreciate anything. Because I had to 3D print the sign that said task in progress and then build it into a box. And I had to order a bulb and then I had to 3D print a cover to cover up that switch so you couldn't see that it was a remote control switch. And all that, and you don't care about any of that. And I was on your side for the whole thing with the basketball and now look what you've done. You ruined my fun. So how many points is that for everybody?
Well, you took 4 seconds, by the way. So that's 5 points for you, and 4 points for Amanda, 3 for Pez, 2 for Derek, and 1 for Ryan.
Yay. Yay for 5 Yay. Points. Hey, Carrie, this taskless existence is unendurable. What have we got next?
Well, this task will tell us if the contestants have anything to hide.
Hide as well as possible. Carrie will count to 100. Longest before Carrie finds you wins.
Hide as well as possible. Carrie will count to 100. Longest before Carrie finds you wins. Backyard.
So what I'm gonna do is good old misdirection. Shh.
I'm gonna hide over there. I don't know if she started looking yet. I don't see her.
I wonder where Carrie's looking right now.
You certainly did.
Found you.
The camera died.
Same. So the task said for them to hide.
Correct.
And it said you would count to 100.
Correct.
It never said you forgot to put the part on there where it said you were going to come look for them.
Correct.
So this was just really an exercise to see who would get fed up the first.
Yes.
That's really cruel, and I'm a little disappointed in you that you do that to these people, Carrie. So Ryan, speaking of duty, what were you taking your tracksuit off for?
All right, so that was the last task of the day. I had been through so much. My poor little baffled brain was completely broke, and I think I had a meltdown.
Yeah.
And decided, what better way to have a meltdown than take off my clothes and crouch in the woods for 45 minutes waiting for someone to find me?
Yeah.
I've done that before.
Yeah.
So how long were they out there, Carrie?
Ryan stayed out 31 minutes and Gina stayed out 39 minutes.
All right. I can't believe you did that to somebody. Who's next?
It's Amanda, Pez, and Derek.
Hide as well as possible. Carrie will count to 100. Longest before Carrie finds you wins.
Okay. Hide as well as possible. Carrie will count to 100. Longest before Carrie finds you wins.
Hide as well as possible. Carrie will count to 100. Longest before Carrie finds you wins. Hope no one else comes back out here in the woods. This will be an awful way to die or get arrested.
Day 43 of the zombie apocalypse. Can only hope FEMA or my friends find me before the creatures of the night do.
Shh, what was that? What was me?
Do 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 do.
Oh, it's raining more.
What's a good name for a daytime vampire?
I wish I knew more about trees.
I'm going stir crazy.
I thought they were coming, but it's been a while now.
I think I've been had. And I think I'm gonna go reveal myself.
Okay.
All done?
Yeah, I think so. I think,
I finally found you.
Yeah, you did. You did finally find me.
Hi. It's 8 o'clock.
I really hope this is not a go hide and be patient and wait and see how long it is type thing. If she's still sitting there, I'm gonna not be happy. You comfy? I started to have my doubts about 20 minutes in. And I was like, how long am I dedicated for this? I was so proud. And there were times I thought that you guys were coming for me. I was like, I hear them. There was also the time a squirrel ran right in front of me. It was really cool.
Where were you at?
I was behind a big tree.
8 o'clock.
Carrie, how long did they stay out there?
Derek stayed out 59 minutes.
Ooh.
Pez stayed out 98 minutes. And Amanda was out for 139 minutes.
Well done.
Two hours and 20 minutes, nearly.
Under
a cover for the grill.
I lost my mind, y'all.
You sounded broken.
Well, you found it again because you brought it today.
I know. Eventually, I brought it back. Yeah.
I didn't bring the task with me, so I was like, was it the shortest or was it the longest? And then I started just like. Keep going back and forth. I was like, okay, well, maybe I'll just wait like another half hour. And then I kept negotiating with myself to just stay longer, even though I wasn't sure. And then my butt started to hurt and I needed to get out at one point. It was a mess. And I am I'm changed. And here's Pez napping.
Well, by the way, they cut out the number. I did a number of little plays, short plays.
Oh, there was a lot. There was a lot in that zombie thing.
I started a podcast while I was out there.
Yeah, there was all kinds of stuff.
I'm realizing maybe I should be a YouTuber. I'm a very interesting person.
So that was 1 point for Ryan, 2 points for Gina, and 3 points for Derek, 4 for Pez, and 5 for Amanda. Yay! Yeah, give them something. All right, so I hope you hear the effects of your wanton cruelty on these people. Do you have something that's a little nicer this time?
Well, in comparison, yes. This task was a little bit shady.
Copy the painting on the wall.
You may not leave the room.
Best copy wins. You have 15 minutes. Your time starts now.
Now, is it this painting?
Yes.
Do I have to make it as big as the paper?
No.
Okay.
And as I've said before, I'm not worried about it because I took a semester of music theory.
Okay. I'm hesitating for no reason. Oh, Carrie, there seems to be something wrong with the lights. Oh no! Is the paint the color that it appears to be? Oh.
I always wanted to fill this with the paint.
Do not fill that with the paint!
Oh boy, you want to have that switch that turns this light on, do you? Wait, there's a switch over here. This does nothing. Okay, and I took my hand off the paint now. Okay.
So, I'm going to assume that purple and green were together since they are the same wavelength.
I got complacent. It's my fault. It was all straightforward so far. Had a good feeling about a lot of things.
This is... it's going to mess me up for life. I'll never do art again in the city.
Just got my hands in some gloop and smearing it around.
I should have put them in rainbow order.
May I take off my shirt?
Sure.
Now, the smart thing to do would have been to look at the different colors that I have available, memorize where they are. But I didn't do that. No. I didn't do that.
Which colors I thought were where.
Now, the bad news is... now I don't know what the other colors are. When I picked one up, and I'm going to hope that it's brown, I'm going to be real with you, it kind of feels like a yellow, but...
how does yellow feel?
Solid.
Woo! Yeah! Look at that! Yeah. That, looks beautiful.
Let me see this.
Oh!
Whoa. What?
This could have been a lot worse.
Yeah. You can either go use the kitchenette or the bathroom. Either way, the kitchenette one's a little bigger.
It looks inverted.
That's strange.
Gina.
when you go to museums, do you often just rip the painting off the wall so you can have a look at it?
I asked her. I'm like, can I take it off the wall? She's like, yeah, it's Velcro.
Yeah, you're the last person. We didn't care what you So let's see what those paintings look like here. Gina, you've got sort of a Hieronymus Bosch thing going on here. It's like a vision of hell. All right, so let's see the next one.
How on earth?
That looks good. It's not bad.
I mean, for being in the dark, it's not bad.
I tried to, at the top, spell out the painting on the wall, because the task was to copy the painting on the wall. This was when I had very little faith in myself.
Makes me want to give you 4 points.
Does that say pass?
Yeah. That says pass.
And you said to someone, well, at least I got the sky in the right place, and I put it to you, sir, that the sky is not in
the right place. No, it's in the bottom. I'm just using the bottom right corner.
Okay.
What's that red bit?
That's the ground. Oh, okay. Which, that was a lucky, happy... Ooh, with Bob Ross, I would say a happy accident.
The blood of his enemies.
Hey!
All right.
Let's see what's kind of happening, I think.
Mm-hmm. At least you got some of the colors right.
Yeah.
Mine are, like, completely wrong. My sky is black.
That gives me kind of a Banksy feel.
Ooh, yeah, there's some weird emotion in there. Yeah.
There's some anger coming out. All right. So I got to judge these, Carrie.
Yes.
I think Derek's looked the most like the original painting, so I'm going to give you 5 points.
Okay.
Ryan's also had a blue sky and some semblance of a shy guy in the middle, so I'm going to give you 4 points. Amanda's had some details, so 3 points for yours.
I had a blue sky and a red ground. Did you even look at the original painting we were trying to attach?
Yes. Gina's dark portal to another dimension is going to get 2 points, and I'm going to give 1 point to Pez for whatever that blob was in the bottom corner. And Carrie must be winding down. So what do we got that highlights our contestants' creative talents?
Well, in this test, beware, because nothing is as it seems. I can never get this seal right. Create an optical illusion. You have 30 minutes. The best illusion wins. Your time starts now.
I want to be taken to a world of imagination and deception.
Well, let's look at Pez's first.
Yeah.
You see? It's a carrot. Wait, no, it's a rabbit, which likes carrots, so I guess the carrot's over here. But you know what? If it needs to swim, and now it's a duck.
You did the rabbit duck thing?
Yeah!
How much time did you take?
Yeah, because, Mike, that was my question, is that you had 30 minutes. Were you late for a meeting or something, or?
I think the rabbit ducks is a solid entry.
You like, thought all of these have been solid entries. You thought that song was a solid entry.
I thought the song was an amazing entry. I just think you're, the Taskmaster, and you get to set the rules the way you
so choose. I think that you're a little delusional is what I think.
I'm a little baffled by your logic.
Can we see the next one, please?
Are you ready to start the task?
What?
All right, it's pretty good.
Where the heck did you get all that stuff?
Around.
And once again, he's stripped down. I don't know what's with all the dudity between you getting naked in the painting room and you're outside in the woods and then...
I've got a base instinct.
Yeah, I guess so. An animal nature. So, you know, could have worked a little better, I think, if the camera had been directly behind and I couldn't see it was a basketball. But I get the idea. What is the next one, Carrie?
I'm so hungry. I can't decide what I want to eat. I guess I'm going to eat everything and the kitchen sink.
I don't know if you guys... picked up on that, but she stopped in the middle of making rumbly tummy noises to say, and more rumbly tummy noises. So, Carrie, that was terrible, but it was at least in the ballpark of what I had in mind, you know, perspective problems. And so let's see the next one.
Okay.
Welcome to Taskmaster. How was your drive in?
It was good. It was a long drive. I feel like I didn't get much sleep, and I drank like 7 cups of coffee on the way up, so now I feel like my eye is all messed up. Could you take a look to see if it's bloodshot?
Sure.
What?
I want to remind you, 30 minutes.
I so, worked so hard on that.
What was it like?
A rock.
So you did an optical illusion.
I did an optical illusion.
Oh, I get it.
It might have worked a little better if during the first part of the sketch your eyeball wasn't sitting on the table. But I guess I see what it. You went for. Oh, I said, when you watch it back, that's all you'll be able to see. Let's see the last one here.
This is my creation, illusion. It's a little airport. They have the gate. This guy says it's taking so long. There's an airplane here, and an airplane kind of outside, and it's square so you can't see it. That's
my God, Carrie, it's like I'm in Detroit Metro. No! So I want to tell everybody, in my four times of being the Taskmaster, this is the most disappointed I think I've been. But
we did it, guys.
But Duck Rabbit!
Yeah, hang on to that. So let's see. We've got to give points to someone. Amanda was in the ballpark of what I was looking for. I'm going to give her 5. I'm going to give Ryan 4 because the idea was pretty good. It just wasn't executed. I think that camera was just behind it. It would have worked better. I can't believe I'm giving Derek's eye 3 points. Yes. Gina's drawing was at least 3D. So 2 points for her. And Pez's half-hearted... you get 1 point for the Highlights magazine puzzle that you recreated. Carrie, can you get that taste out of my mouth?
Well, our last task is at least very simple.
Or is it?
I have regrets.
Put the bead in the glass. Time stops when the bead is in the glass and you say done. You have 1 attempt. You may not leave the room. Your time starts now. Done? You're welcome.
Looking for hidden letters. Put the bead in the glass. Time stops when the bead is in the glass and you say done. You have 1 attempt. You may not leave the room. Your time starts now. Done.
They seem very suspicious, Carrie. It does seem strangely straightforward for one of our tasks.
Let's see if Ryan figures it out.
Thank you.
Put the bead in the glass. Time stops when the bead is in the glass, and you say done. You have 1 attempt. You may not leave the room. Your time starts now. The show makes me paranoid about everything. It shouldn't be this stressful. I mean, done? No problem.
See, he's sort of suspicious too. Was that a real glass?
Yes.
And was it a real bead?
Yes.
All right, I give up. What were they actually supposed to do?
All they had to do was put the bead in the glass.
Hmm. Sneaky.
I don't feel good.
I do not feel good.
Let's see Pez and Derek.
Yes!
No!
Hi, Carrie. Pez. How are you doing today?
Good, how are you doing?
Getting a little sweaty now. Oh. Thank you for asking. Everybody ready? Put this bead in the glass. Time stops when the bead is in the glass and you say done. You have 1 attempt. Do not leave the room. Your time starts. Put the bead in the glass. This time stops when the bead...
feel like this is a mug, not a glass.
See if I can open this better this time. Nope. Ooh. I think the secret is going from right to left. All right. Put the bead in the glass. Time stops when the bead is in the glass and you say done. You have one attempt. You may not leave the room. No way. I'm going to ask some questions.
Is this a bead? This, to me, is a bead. You have one attempt. Do not leave the room. The bead in the glass. You may not leave the room.
Is there more than one? Am I missing a bead? This, okay. Is this the glass?
Yes.
And this is the bead?
Yes.
Has time started? Oh, it did. I said time starts now. Okay. Done. I just probably lost points because I took that long. But whatever.
Did you find like a bead?
Is there another glass outside this room?
I'm sure.
Is this a glass?
Yes.
Is this a bead?
Yes.
Good question.
Done?
Done?
You guys are so suspicious. Do we look like somebody who would do anything sneaky?
According to hide and seek, yes.
Carrie, what were their times?
Amanda was the fastest at 5 seconds, followed by Gina at 10 seconds. Ryan took 27 seconds. Derek took 40 seconds. And Pez took 1 minute 37 seconds to move a bead about 2 feet.
Well, congratulations. So I think that just leaves us with the final task.
Stick a sticker to the correct body part. The taskmaster will say the names of 3 body parts. You must stick a sticker to the body part that comes second in the dictionary out of the 3 body parts. The slowest person to stick a sticker to the correct body part is eliminated.
All right. So we'll do that until there's only one person left. All right. Is everybody ready?
Mm-hmm. I guess.
All right. The first 3 words. Knee. Elbow, face. All right, I think Ryan was the slowest. Everybody got it. So Ryan, you're out. If you could take a seat over there. Next words are clavicle, pelvis, ankle.
No.
All right, I think Gina is the slowest. So I'm sorry, Gina. We're gonna have to take you out. Next 3 words, phalanges, hips, humerus.
Oh, no.
Where's yours at? Nope, we got, Derek is right, but we still got 2 people who are not right.
What were the words again?
Phalanges, hips, humerus. Still not quite correct.
Makes you guys feel better, I guess.
Oh, yeah, Amanda's got it. Pez, if you can have a seat over here. Last one for the 5 points. Philtrum, heel, trapezius. And Derek's got it. The philtrum is right up above your lip there. Ugh. So let's see what that does for the points.
Well done.
Carrie, what are the final scores?
In last place with 22 points is Pez.
Yay! Yay, me, I participated.
Next is Gina with 30 points. Well done. Next is Ryan with 33 points. And the winner of Michigan Taskmaster 4.
By how many points?
By 3 points. Is Amanda with 41 points.